Eversheds, Sutherland. My name's Indraj Mangat. I'm one of the banking partners here. I'm very happy to host the Stephenson lecture tonight. I would like to welcome Diversity UK, and in particular, Luke Patel, MBE, who's the founder, and Josh MBE, who's the chair of Diversity UK as well. I also go ahead our BAME network here at the firm. It was set up about 4 or 5 months ago. It currently has about 105 members. The main aim of it is to try to look at our the BAME diversity in the firm itself, and try to create a more level of playing field in terms of what we have here, attract more people to the firm, and try to help people in terms of their promotion. The firm itself sees diversity and inclusion as a key part of its strategy. And it all comes within one umbrella, and effectively is split up into the various sections. We are, as an employer, regarded in the top 50 for gender diversity and social diversity, and are one of the top 100 employers for studying. However, I think it's true to say that in terms of BAME, we are a little behind, but I don't think that's only us. I mean, my personal experience is that city law firms have not been the most attractive institutions when it comes to paying candidates. It won't surprise any of you that I'm not a millennial. I missed that by a couple of years. when I qualified in 1989, I was one of a handful of BAME individuals in a city law firm. And at that time, and until very recently, it was kind of taboo to kind of talk about BAME inclusion in firms. You were kind of regarded, or you were supposed to regard yourself as being one of the few, the privileged few, to be part of city law firm. Therefore, you wouldn't bring issues like that up, because effectively it would be seen as clear losing. I, for one, in terms of the BAME report we've got, am very pleased that now this is a conversation everyone can have. And certainly in terms of Eversheds, support from our senior executive, they are fully behind what needs to be done in the firm in terms of attracting more people. I mean, one of the first things that we did as a firm was to actually have a third party come in to look at and to talk to our BAME members to see what issues they've got. And as a whole, I think it's an issue which I think a lot of institutions still have, is that there are very few role models for them to actually look up to, which then generates its own issues in terms of the fact that they don't have anybody to talk to in relation to actually progressing their own careers. And therefore, one of the key aspects that we've got to try to challenge and take forward is actually ensuring that there are more BAME members at the top table, because only if that happens, then effectively inclusion does happen. So, I think what I would say to anyone here who's a chief executive or a partner of a law firm, or anybody who is a successful a member of the BAME community, successful in his own career, is that look at your own firms, look at your own groups, see what contribution there is, and try to help it. Because one of my concerns, and I talked about this when we first met, is that at the moment, because of things like the Me Too movement and the other movements at the moment, there is this momentum. And I think one of the concerns I have is that as soon as the press or other people get distracted with other things, with the Brexit or something else, the momentum dies off and therefore disappears away. And I think it's key for individuals involved in such networks and for pressure groups like Diversity UK to actually keep this thing on the agenda and start moving. And one of the key things for me, and again we talked about that, is convincing this government that just as they are happy to have targets, agenda, that's going to be interesting to claim itself. And I think just to show how progressive this government is, that is something that we are talking seriously about, and it is something that we will be introducing as a firm. And I suspect that we're probably, certainly probably one of the few, if not the first, city law firm to actually do introduce paying targets. And hopefully, when that's picked up by other institutions, then they will follow. So welcome all, and I'd just like to introduce Josh, who's been instrumental in arranging this event. Take the words.